Here we will discuss relationship between partial pressure and mole fraction. Let us say we have a cubical box and this closed container contains different gases. So the blue one, let us call this as a gas of type 1. So this is gas 1. Now the red one is different kind of molecule. So let us call this as a gas 2. Similarly, these molecules let us say call gas 3. So now this molecule, basically this box, contains a mixture of gas molecules. So I can say container contains a mixture of gas molecules. Now let us say moles of gas 1 is N1. So what is N1? N1 is the mole of gas 1. Moles of gas 1. Similarly, I have N2, that is moles of gas 2. And let us say N3 I have, that is moles of gas 3. Similarly, if possible, we can have more number of moles. So we can define total number of moles. So total moles, this is equals to N1 plus N2 plus N3. Now we define something called mole fraction. So mole fraction is nothing but, so if I say mole fraction of component 1 or gas 1, and in short this is denoted by x with a subscript 1, this is mole of 1 divided by total mole. So mole of 1 is N1, and this divided by total mole, N1 plus N2 plus N3, or we can call this as N tot. Total mole can be written as N tot. So this is nothing but N1 divided by N tot. Similarly, we can write mole fraction of gas 2. This is equals to x with subscript 2. And this is again N2 divided by total moles, N1 plus N2 plus N3. So we will have N2 divided by N tot. If possible, we can again write for N3 mole fraction of component 3. This is N3 divided by N1 plus N2 plus N3, and this is N3 divided by N tot. Now we can apply ideal gas equation for gas 1, or we can also apply ideal gas equation as a whole. So let us apply ideal gas equation for gas 1. So if I apply PV is equals to nRT, so for gas 1 we can say partial pressure of P1. And what is this? P1 is partial pressure due to gas 1. So partial pressure due to gas 1. So we can write P1 into V, because volume is total. So let us say gas container has a volume of V. So V is basically container volume. And gas is free to move anywhere, so this total volume is occupied by gas number 1 also, and the mole number of moles of 1 is N1 R into T, and T is the temperature of the vessel. So let us say T is the temperature of vessel. Now we can also apply ideal gas equation as a whole. So this we have applied ideal gas equation for gas 1. We can also apply as a whole. So let us apply ideal gas equation as a whole. Then we can say total pressure into volume. This is equals to total number of moles into R into T. So this is equation number 2. Now if we divide equation 1 by equation 2, so we will have P1V divided by P tot into V N1RT divided by N tot into R into T, where P dot denotes the total pressure inside the box. So P dot basically denotes total pressure inside the box. Now if I divide these two, V goes out, RT here goes out, so we will have P1 by P dot, this is equals to N1 by N dot, and N1 by N dot is nothing but mole fraction of component 1. So you see here X1, that is the mole fraction of 1, is N1 by N dot. So this is basically equals to X1. So now we can write P1 by P dot, this is equals to X1, or we can write P1 is equals to P dot into X1. Now this relation is important. What is the meaning of this equation is partial pressure due to 1, partial pressure due to gas 1 is equals to total pressure multiplied by the mole fraction of gas 1, mole fraction of gas 1. This means if I know the mole fraction and if I know the total pressure, we can calculate the partial pressure. And let us say one example. In air, we know there are 78% is nitrogen. So mole fraction of nitrogen in air, that is 78%, that is 78 by 100. So this is 0.78. So this means we know mole fraction of nitrogen in air. So let us say this is given. Mole fraction of nitrogen in air, this is equals to 0.78, and we also know total pressure, environment total pressure. So total pressure is 1 atmospheric pressure. So total pressure, and this is equals to 1 atmospheric pressure. So now we can calculate what is the partial pressure due to nitrogen. So partial pressure due to nitrogen, that is PN2, and this is equals to total pressure into mole fraction of nitrogen. So you see P total is 1 atmospheric pressure and mole fraction is 0.78. So we can say pressure applied due to nitrogen is only 0.78 atmospheric pressure. So this means if total pressure and mole fraction is given, we can calculate partial pressure. Sometime partial pressure and mole fraction is given, we can also calculate total pressure. So if I rearrange, so we will have P total is equals to P N2 divided by X N2, or we can say P1 divided by X1. So P total can also be calculated using this formula, P1 divided by 1, so that is partial pressure of 1 divided by mole fraction of component 1.